Greetings, friends, and welcome to today's Family Altar Audio Devotional. Our scripture reading today comes to us from the book of John, chapter 12, verses 20 through 21, and the quote is by William Marion Branham from the message entitled, Sir, We Would See Jesus. This message was preached on August the 28th, 1955. We hope that you are blessed today as you listen. And there were certain Greeks among them that came up to worship at the feast. The same came therefore to Philip, which was of Bethsaida of Galilee, and desired him, saying, Sir, we would see Jesus.
Now these Greeks that came to Philip,
ces Grecs qui sont venus à Philippe,
their heart's desire,
le désir de leur cœur,
was to see Jesus,
était de voir Jésus.
How many have that same desire tonight?
Combien ont ce même désir ce soir?
Everyone.
Tout le monde.
We all want to see.
Nous voulons tous le voir.
That's the call of the human heart.
C'est l'appel du cœur humain.
Sir,
mais
we would see Jesus.
Nous voudrions voir Jésus.
Now that's what we want to do tonight.
C'est cela que nous voulons faire ce soir.
Let's just think a minute.
Pensons, réfléchissons un instant.
Now let's just get away from all our fantastic ideas.
Éloignons-nous de toute idée de fantaisie.
And if he's so real,
et si lui est vrai et réel,
as Christians claim he
aussi réel que les chrétiens le déclarent,
why can't we see?
Pourquoi ne pouvons-nous le voir?
We say he's not dead.
Nous disons il n'est pas mort.
That he's living.
Donc il est vivant.
He said he'd be with us.
Il a déclaré qu'il serait avec nous.
And every generation.
Et toute génération, et que toutes les générations le verraient, jusqu'à la fin du monde. Jésus a promis cela. Il a déclaré encore un peu de temps, les incrédules ne me verront plus, mais vous me verrez, car je serai avec vous jusqu'à la fin du monde. Et toute génération
a été promise.
A reçu la promesse
to see him.
Qu'elle le verrait.
So, let's take a look for him tonight.
Alors, regardons et recherchons-le donc ce soir.
I want to see.
Je veux le voir.
I remember one time,
je me souviens d'une fois,
I was getting up my little old cabin.
Je montais dans ma petite cabane,
cold,
froid.
I was trying to make a fire.
J'essayais d'allumer un feu.
And all it wouldn't burn.
Et le bois ne voulait pas brûler.
And I turned on the radio.
Et j'ai tourné le bouton de la radio.
And a sister was singing,
et une sœur chantait,
I want to see Jesus.
Je désire voir Jésus.
I just sat down on the floor.
Ah, je me suis assis par terre.
And I started weeping.
Et alors les larmes commencèrent à couler. J'ai levé les deux mains.
Yes, Lord.
Et j'ai dit, oui, Seigneur,
I want to see you.
Je veux te voir.
And you want to see.
Et vous voulez le voir.
And if he is so real,
et s'il est aussi réel,
why can't we see?
Mais pourquoi ne pouvons-nous le voir?
If you were looking for him tonight,
si vous le cherchiez ce soir,
what type of person would you look for?
Quel genre de personne rechercheriez-vous?
Would you look for a man in long robes?
Est-ce que vous attendriez à trouver un homme avec une longue robe?
Dressed different from other men?
Habillé différemment des autres hommes?
Not Jesus.
Non, pas Jésus.
He dressed just like other men.
Il s'habillait tout comme les autres.
If he was here in the body of flesh tonight,
s'il était ici dans la chair ce soir,
he'd wear a suit of clothes like we have.
Il aurait un complet tout comme nous.
Yeah. And we couldn't look for a well-dressed man.
Et nous ne pourrions pas non plus chercher un homme bien habillé.
And I don't imagine he would look like he was from a bandbox.
Et je ne pense pas qu'on aurait pensé qu'il sortait exactement immédiatement de chez le tailleur.
We wouldn't go out to the great cathedrals to find him.
Nous n'irions pas dans les grandes cathédrales pour le trouver.
Or when he was here.
Car lorsqu'il était ici,
they wouldn't receive him.
On ne voulait pas le recevoir.
And they wouldn't again tonight.
Et ce soir, ce serait la même chose, on ne le recevrait pas.
Would you go to a man that had a great forceful voice?
Iriez-vous vers un homme qui aurait une voix forte?
Non. Would you look for a man that had a great swelling education?
Chercheriez-vous un homme d'une grande érudition?
That had so much education till he continually spoke in tongues?
Jusqu'à avoir une telle érudition, instruction qu'il continue à parler constamment en langue?
Just So drama people couldn't understand him.
À tel point que l'homme du peuple ne pourrait le comprendre.
Not Jesus.
Non, pas Jésus.
He talked like common people.
Il parlait comme tous les hommes.
So where would you find him?
Alors, où le trouveriez-vous?
You'd have to find him among the common people.
Il faudrait le trouver parmi les gens humbles.
He'd be a common man.
Ce serait un homme humble, ordinaire.
Then what would he be doing?
Alors, que serait-il en train de faire?
Bragging on his education?
Se vanter de son érudition, de son instruction?
Bragging on his affiliation in churches?
Se vantant de son affiliation à telle ou telle église?
Non. Would he be bragging he was a healer?
Serait-il en train de se vanter d'être un guérisseur?
Non. He'd be saying, not me.
Il le serait en train de dire, mais ce n'est pas moi.
It's the Father.
C'est le Père.
That dwelleth in me.
Qui demeure en moi.
He does the work.
C'est lui qui fait les œuvres.
If thou canst believe,
si tu peux croire,
all things are possible.
Toutes choses sont possibles.
He would look out over the audience.
Il regarderait par-dessus l'auditoire.
The people suffering.
Et voyant toutes ces personnes qui souffrent,
he'd say when they had faith,
il leur dirait que lorsqu'ils auraient la foi,
daughter,
c'est ma fille,
or child,
ou mon enfant,
thy faith has saved thee,
ta foi t'a sauvé
from such and such disease,
de telle ou telle maladie.
That the father would tell him something,
et si le père lui disait encore quelque chose,
he'd speak it out to the audience,
il parlerait à l'auditoire.
That's the kind of Jesus,
selon ce que Dieu lui avait dit. C'est ce Jésus-là que...
We trust that you have been blessed by God's Word today. The devotional you just heard was derived from Brother Tim Dodd's Family Altar devotional book. If you are interested in a copy of your own, you can visit store.bibleway.org to order your own copy. If you would like to listen to more daily Family Altar audio devotionals and other spiritual message-related content that we produce, we invite you to subscribe to the 10,000 Worlds podcast or visit us on YouTube, Facebook, and on our website at 10kworlds.com. That's the number 10, the letter K, and the word worlds.com. If you feel that this ministry has been a blessing to you, and you would like to support us financially to help us deliver more and better content to you in the future, you may easily do so by clicking the Consider Supporting Us link in the description of this episode, or visiting our website to learn more. It's okay if you can't support us financially, but would you do us a favor? Pray for us and share this episode with others so that they might be blessed as well. Lastly, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell button so that you get notified when we publish more content like this. Thank you, and God bless you.